So friends, now when we compare the results obtained after using Autodoc 4.2 and Autodoc Vena, what you can see, first difference is in a docking score. Although we have selected the same ligand molecule camphorol and docked with the protein 6LU7, but the docking score using Autodoc 4.2 is suggesting -7.16, whereas the results of Autodoc Vena is suggesting the docking score -7.7. Even the amino acid residue, that is the position of a docking, is not exactly matching. Although you can see the highlighted portion which I have shown here is the same amino acid residue that I docked using Autodoc 4.2, but there are some amino acid residue, that is leucine, histidine, serine and cysteine, that are new which is not available using Autodoc 4.2 result. So let us compare the results more detail. Okay, so further comparison, what I will do, I will open both the results obtained after using Autodoc 4.2 and Autodoc Vena into the same window. So let us go to the analyze tab and open Autodoc Vena result. That is the output file. And in this case, let me select the first option, that is a multiple molecules. So when you select this option, you can see overlapping structures are being generated because all the 9 conformations are obtained in a single window. Okay. Next, go to the analyze, again open docking results of Autodoc 4.2. So docking results of Autodoc 4.2 is in a form of a DLG file, so let me open that. So it will open Autodoc 4.2 result. Now go to the macromolecule and open your macromolecule. Macromolecule is 6LU7. So macromolecule is also open. Now what I will do, let me convert this macromolecule into a ribbon format. And unhide the sticks. So now you can see there is a clear view. Now let us compare. For that, click here in the play mode. Okay. So what I have did, I have opened all the molecules first. That is the output results obtained using Autodoc Vena. Second, the DLG file, that is again the results obtained using Autodoc 4.2. And third, 6LU7, that is the protein structure. The gray color portion is representing your 6LU7 protein structure. This highlighted part, you can see this highlighted part is representing your results, that is the camphorol docking position obtained after using Autodoc 4.2, and the rest of the structures are representing the 9 conformations of output file. Now if suppose let me compare the dock position of Autodoc 4.2 with the first output model 1, so for that I have to hide the rest of the model. So let us click on this and hide rest of the model and keep only the model 1. So I am hiding all the rest of the 8 model. Okay. Okay. So only 2 conformations are now available. So 3 things are now open. First, the gray color part is representing what? The gray color part is representing the 6LU7. Now, this selected part is representing the camphorol docking position using Autodoc 4.2. And now, this part is representing again the camphorol position but the results obtained using Autodoc 4. Sorry, the results obtained using Autodoc Vena. So you can see there is a bit difference in the docking position of the same molecule, that is camphorol, using the Autodoc 4.2 and Autodoc Vena. So that's why the difference in this amino acid residue, that's why the difference in a docking score of results of the same ligand, that is camphorol with 6LU7, but we are using two different program, Autodoc 4.2 for the first result and Autodoc Vena for the second result. So in this way you can compare between the results of Autodoc 4.2 and Autodoc Vena. So I hope it is an interesting session to all of you. Thank you very much. Stay tuned to Quicklearn 360 for further such a kind of very knowledgeable and interesting video. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Quicklearn 360 brings to you a fun of learning, knowledge and better understanding. Stay connected. Stay tuned to us.